Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're back here with Rome 2 Total War. We have slightly expanded. We have got numerous legions slowly being rebuilt. They've taken some damage. Of course, we need to sort of sort that out. Otherwise, they won't be combat effective for very long. So that's going to take a bit of time. They're getting into work. And of course, we've got to figure out where do we head next. I mean, west is a option there. We got the Volcae. So the west of that would overall sort of expand our Provincia province, very imaginatively named. They are at war with the Averni and the slaves. They're pretty much on their own. I think we should all react to be able to crush them pretty quickly. So I think that's something worth looking into there.
I am here to listen if you speak.
So I think that is something very well worth looking into.
Be welcome.
They don't seem to be interested in us.
I think trade a bad idea. We do not want simple folk to be scared of the marketplace.
There's a bit there to consider as well. And the Averni.
The guards will have me listen to you.
But yeah, I think we'll hit the Volcae and basically sort of just deal with them before the Averni take them on, in which case we have to fight them instead just to expand our little province. And I'd overall just try and get as much out. Obviously, we've got to deal with the rebels there first. We'll move in the second legion. They should be able to push through rapidly, I think. I mean, they might not be in the world's sort of most elite legion, but they still got a bunch of the Sorci Astarte, a bit of other bits there, and they should all be able to push through there. Obviously, again, we got to deal with them. Hopefully, our depleted army there can do the trick. We might soften up a bit there with some poisoning of the provisions. There we go. That should ease in the job there. We'll assist with further legions here. And overall, we sort of got a nice sort of financial boost, which is overall quite appreciated. What we're looking for here, we'll be sending our Shrine of Jupiter to help countenance the Punic culture they're spreading from those chaps. Those dastardly naughty chaps. And we'll be sending up here some food and money. Let's first see here if that happens, how that goes. Alright, they'll be quickly swept away by the glorious Roman legions. Which of course then opens up for our second legion to quickly pass through and hit the Volcae. We can of course further soften up using our spies. And here, I mean overall, if we're sort of, well, I am planning of sort of setting up here a military outpost here, since we'll overall got a pretty decent position. It's not a big province, meaning I'm not going to get so much else out of it. It'll be able to sort of push northwards, southwards, and support also in the east. So I'll sort of set up here for a province, setting up some ballistas as well. Lastly, Provincia will become the military province. I have now decided in my eternal wisdom. And what we got here? Setting up that one. And again, maybe some extra wealth would be good, but I mean, obviously, more military here would suit it. That would obviously suit it quite a bit. So I guess we'll set up a military wharf as well. And I think with that we end the turn.
We hunger for battle.
And hope that the Volcae don't get beaten by the Averni. So far looks good. I don't even know the massage they were. Alright. There's a Tanya standing about. They do have some army standing about here, but mostly freemen, really, with some mercenary Celtic warriors. They should thusly not compose a bigger issue.
I do enjoy a little trouble.
Didn't work out. Still working out. I think I'll wait a bit of time just to grab some extra men here before pushing into their territory. No point in setting myself up for any nasty surprises that could come out of nowhere, and we've certainly had those before. Oh, looks like we managed to nab a Greek ballista there. Fancy that. we're setting up military here, that doesn't make so much sense. I think we'll just wreck that one actually, set up something else. And here we will just continue with that one. Agriculture, and here we'll set up for that as well. Overall plan now, of course, besides expanding into Tulsa, is just to boost the economy so we can sort of prosecute further wars more efficiently with bigger armies, more well-supported armies. That's the general plan at the moment. There we go. Massalia suddenly begins to look more Roman now. So we like it, we'll set up the practice field, and here we can actually sort of begin going up for something bigger. Moving on from this to this, getting auxiliary naked swords if you want to. And that we can also train some troops here. Astarte wise, less armored, but better combat ability. Also, a lot cheaper. A lot cheaper. Celtic warriors, even cheaper. Also more damaging in some sense. Obviously, again, not so armored, but as we've seen, it doesn't seem to count so much in the Astarte anyways. So rather seems to be a better job getting something else to fight with to sort of compare these two. I mean, these are obviously more offensively oriented, where these are sort of a bit more defensive. But again, they are cheaper. I think we'll go for these, though. Then we'll set up for them and then push towards that one. Trying to stir up some more trouble in the process. I will see it done. Weaken the defenders.
Succeeding is what I do. My skills know few bounds.
There we go. Gets better at what he does, that is good.
Ready for battle. Advance.
Second legion ready for support. We also got the workshop open. We can actually pull up another set of ballistas there. So with that, we should be able to quickly overwhelm the Volcae at Tolosa. Seize that one. And that should overall be pretty good. I actually wonder how our gold's coming along there. Oh, we need to get a full province. Magna Carta we don't have, but I think we'll survive that one. Be at war with Carthage. I mean, I suppose we could do that, but I don't know. I don't think there's much financial benefit in going to war with them right away, compared to just having a full military province ready and just sort of taking all of Gaul. It's a navy. Other houses can get that one. Management. Oh, that one. We're still reaching elsewhere, there we go. That's gonna take a bit. Political intrigue. It's unfortunate. Is unfortunate, but right.
How can I be of assistance, mischief and mayhem?
Commander. Siege to the settlement.
Right, moving up and attacking.
We take this settlement for Rome.
Even all the poisoning, they've still got something there to assist with. Obviously, that is not all we are bringing to the fight. Anything but. We also got a load of artillery.
Your next command.
There we go, at that point it's pretty much just easily over. No point in fighting a war of attrition if you can just break them, roughly. Going with that, we got any problems as well. And with that, victory is ours in this area.
At your command.
Which is what we like to see in here. Things are looking pretty good. In fact, I believe I can begin considering recruiting another legion.
I want hourly patrols.
I should. Well, again, I could go for the Principes, but again, I might as well go for something cheaper. So I actually should have raced it down there. That was silly of me. I'm just used to racing in Rome. It just feels right, you know, racing the legion in Rome, then sending it downwards to the south, you know, for tax purposes, to get, you know, cheaper troops that will perform the same. You know, it's very Italian and all that. Very Italian.
Ready for orders. Oh,
there you go. And now to plot the next campaign. It'll probably be against the Averni, I think. They're already there. They're just a bunch of barbarians anyways. Who's going to miss them? Ah, that's a shame. That's a big shame, actually. She was a good spy, really, so... Sad to see you go. Oh well. We'll pop up a new one.
Commander.
We'll otherwise set up preparations here for the next stage of the campaign. Looks like they're a bit of war, but we'll be setting up, I think, for two pushes there.
At your command.
This legion good to go as well. I think we'll have them support the push here, I think. This army should already be stronger. Strongish. This one's also pretty strong though. Oh well. And sending this one south. Where is it? Don't tell me just oh, he died. Ah, oh, he did. I raised the legion and then the guy. Talk about bad luck. The 4th Legion, the only Legion never to really get anywhere because the only guy in it died. That's just disgraceful.
Soldiering. It's a good life.
There you go.
Ready for battle, at your command. Ready for orders. Champion of Rome. Come on.
I am a champion of Rome. I said let's step for a harbour. Get some more money flowing. Oh. Apparently we already did that, so now our coffers are literally exploding. That's pretty good. That is pretty good for us, less good for those who oppose us. Right, they are there.
Ready for battle. My sword is yours. 1, 2, 3, 4.
They're pretty big there, so yeah, more legions here makes sense. I'll probably wait a bit with this one here in the west before pushing in there. That could, I think, very quickly be a bit ugly if we're not careful. mean, they are mostly just this, but, you know, a wrong move, they could quickly send all of these units to their death. And that wouldn't be very interesting, now would it? Well, obviously for my viewers it might be entertaining, but I'm pretty sure my men would prefer that was not the case. So... right then, next turn I guess we'll hit Epibracht, which is the capital with two legions, and south here. We'll sort of strike there with the second legion, and the other one down here still growing. They'll be able to grow so fast, so that's good. That is good. I suppose I could shift our fleet a bit further to supporting in the west. Do a bit of naval raiding, though that's going to take ages to get around Spain, so probably not. Probably not. Even better, they abandoned, they retook Nemossos, which leaves Bordigala open to my legion in Tolosa. More likely means, well, they'll probably attract some attention on the back way, but they won't be too suffering there. I guess we'll do the management bit there. First reconnaissance to spot out their naughties, there we go. And they seem to be suffering from attritional issues, that is good. They're getting another spy there. Got the Pictornas as defensive allies, and they are those at war with the Sicitani. I'm not too worried about the Pictornas, so let's hit Bordigala. Okay, not much of a fight there, so we quickly seize that one. And cut down the defenders. So that's the sort of the one element there of our opening moves of the campaign against them. Turn this into something better. You can get some pretty good troops here, so I might as well do it with one of them. Go. I could move at Nemossus, I guess. Or not. Something seems to be blocking movement a bit, but oh well. We'll hit the light of Belenos here south of Ibracte. Ambush. And dead. Leaving Ibracte open to a counterattack of full assault. Practically a blitzkrieg. Seizing two of the biggest cities in one fell swoop. Completely overwhelming them. At your command. Keep them close there so they can defend, and that pretty much means we got sort of cut off here and cut off here. Leaving all these sort of more stuff together, bit here at Bisancio, and that's really all they all of a sudden got left there, and that means the units aren't well supplied, they'll suffer attrition, they'll bleed out, which is good for us. Very good. So there's overall looking pretty good, I think, for the most part. Pretty good. And of course, this means a lot of resources my way. On the next turn, as we strike fear and dread into the hearts of those chaps. So yeah, looking, I would say, pretty good there. Looking pretty good. For now, and again, we got a legion here, so in case something happens in this department, we could sort of quickly get that one in there. And in theory, we got enough resources to at least, you know, quickly get another one on the feet as well. Ready for orders. So it's overall looking pretty promising. Oh, they had a few troops sneaking about there. We can deal with them quickly and ruthlessly. Celtic Barian Confederation. That's the second confederation that seems to have sort of appeared. Oh, they got some territory down there in Spain. Actually, I did not realize that. That needs to be dealt with.
What do you wish of me?
Alright. They should not be combat worthy soon enough. Should probably be dealt with by the First Legion. And yeah, that's pretty much quickly dealt with. I mean, actually, most of the northern Alvani territory has then gained in about two turns. That's pretty good. That is pretty good. Yes, sir. Less upkeep is always good.
Ready for orders.
Set that one up, and I don't know. That one, I guess.
We hunger for battle.
Leaving Confederation, and can't see the other one. Oh well. At war with the Navi, and the Navi at war with, well, a bunch of others, really. There's a lot of fighting going on up in the north. I'm tempted to push towards Visonti as quickly as possible. That will mean I have to deal with a rebellion there, so I'll probably have to wait.
Ready for battle. Ready for orders.
I think I'll quickly shift the Legion north here. We can force marches since we're pretty sure not to get assaulted by someone and get ambushed. Which is good. Which is very good. At this point, I could just as well raise another Legion talent. Oh, hello. Gold. Gold is good. So, agriculture here. More food, but more importantly, more gold. To pay for the legions. To pay for victory. But yeah, quickly sort of expanding now. After the initial hurdles there. And again, I could probably set about starting up another legion. So there we go. Can't quite hire Sorki Astarte, so I make to do with regular Astarte, though in theory I could make use of Celts, but too many and it just feels a bit weird, so sneak in a few on some auxiliary infantry. Right, we got a bunch of people already ranking up, we're probably here. Here. And thusly. That one is a bit unexpected. But again, I for some reason assumed all south basically down there was Carthage. Kind of was in my last campaign. But in this case, that wasn't quite the case. So now the general basically sort of files out. Alright. I'll deal with the smaller one more quickly because that one could quickly become a pain in the posterior with a few mercenaries suddenly appearing out of a blind angle, so might as well deal with that one first before dealing with the bigger one. That's basically my perspective at the moment. Deal with it before it becomes a problem I really need to deal with. Got a big army here. Send our spies after it. Pause the provisions and get an idea of the state of the army, not the most advanced one. State of forces though should allow us to take that one out. Got artillery, got a lot of infantry. Not so much range, but you know, details, details. Alrighty. It's largely just levy freemen and some skirmishers set up. Well, with the artillery, I could probably shoot them to bits. And then have sort of the principes of the map. Let's fight that one out. Then we have the Hastati and the cavalry flank them. There you go. A lot of filthy barbarians setting up our catapults or ballistas there for maximum death. So fine. Ah, there you go. The maximum range. Jolly good. Principis, Astarte.
Grouped and awaiting orders.
Ah, you're supposed to join in there, actually. Go. Do these advance? Yes, they do. They actually advance. Meaning, I have an easy job here. As I just then have to blast them to bits with my ballista as they march into it. Really big siege machinery. Greek and Roman, pretty much no difference apparently, except in armor. Sure that works. Pretty sure they carry about the same level of... actually they wear chainmail in legionary outfits, more or less, actually. Funny again how they sort of get a bit inconsistent there. But well, not the biggest issue. Let's just bunch things a bit further forward. Considering they're all bunched up, I think explosive rounds would be quite nice. I don't know if they actually had explosive rounds then. I mean, what was your stuff in it? Like... It seems like an odd one, they're just very anachronistic, you know, the Romans just so happened to have explosives, you know, ye old C4. There we go. Fireworks. There we go. Huge casualties. Theoretically, anyways. I don't know. I think I'll switch over to regular rounds. Can't help but few of these aren't quite getting the job done, seeing as most of the shots are actually missing. Whereas these one tend to kill more because, hey, they're more accurate and they just sort of pass through more in a sense. in particular with the more dense formations anyways. So while they look more flashy, I mean, the regular shots I feel always end up doing a lot more damage. Oh, hello. That's a surprise. I was too occupied with the artillery show that I missed the other bits. Already there, some are wavering, the shots just crashing their bones and their friends. Turning to a bit of an impact there on morale, if you will. I don't think I ordered you to move, but you know. Feel free to get yourself horribly murdered. Really quite a mess there. Bit of a scrum. Over there, the carrier's getting decimated. Excellent, as hoped. The artillery ended up doing a lot. They want to switch to rocky rounds, whatever you call it. The Pictorna's men are getting absolutely slaughtered.
Equites, forward! Principes!
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
General! Ave! Benitez!
Pretty sure that you to attack there, not go forwards, they're a bit back, you know, just do what's told. Be the most appreciated element. There we go. The entire Pictona's army is completely collapsing now. Their O-Sworn to, well, stand and die with the rest, are, well, in the process of dying with the rest. And the there you go, we'll suddenly find themselves very, very isolated. If they haven't already, no, they're still there. Just briefly look for a small moment that they have run off. There we go. And then the ballista end up doing quite a bit of damage there to our opponent's forces. There we go, a full rout here from the Pictornas. Their army shattered, running like the ragged filth they are. There you go. And let's finish off the blighters. Then we can move to take the remaining city, which we can then sort of use to seize the entire province. Which would actually give us some bonuses. That province has iron, which overall works quite nicely for the rest. Looks towards Limonium. And I think with that we'll actually be stopping the episode here. But some bigger battles ahead. So thank you all for joining in. Hope you enjoyed this episode. If you didn't subscribe, like, share, and comment on it. This is Imperial Dane signing off. I'll be back in another 2 days with another exciting episode. I hope. Cheers, everybody.